you've had a chance to visit our wireless power overview at ti.com/wirelesspower. The overview covers many topics of interest to those of you just getting into wireless power and those of you looking to expand your knowledge. Hi, I'm Dick Stacey, an applications engineer on TI's battery management solutions team. In this session, I'm going to discuss the tools used for foreign object detection, or FOD. Both the receiver and transmitter have to address the issue, but this will focus on the receiver FOD. For this discussion, a foreign object is anything that will interfere with the magnetic field created by the transmitter that's not part of the solution. When placed inside the power transfer area, they can absorb the energy being transmitted and heat up, which can result in a poor user experience. When a receiver is placed on the transmitter will begin to send power to the receiver, which in turn will negotiate for the power it needs for its system. During normal operation, with no foreign object, the power transmitted equals the power received. When a foreign object is inserted into the system, it will absorb some of the energy sent from the transmitter. The receiver will then need to request more power from the transmitter to compensate for the power lost to the foreign object. The wireless system may be able to determine if there's a foreign object present by comparing the received power reported to the transmitter with the actual transmitted power. If this delta becomes too large, there is something in the area absorbing the excess transferred power. Once a preset threshold for maximum allowable power loss is reached, the transmitter is required to prevent the object from increasing past a given temperature threshold. In general, the transmitter will stop power transfer and set an error flag. Many of the TI transmitters will decrease the power being sent in an attempt to keep within an acceptable level in order to continue power delivery without creating excessive power losses. Calibration is required by the receiver system to ensure it sends the correct power level to the transmitter. Calibration is required to account for any expected friendly metal losses. Examples of friendly metals include cameras, speakers, batteries, screws, and connectors. The receiver coil shielding is not only used to direct the magnetic field to the coil, but also to block as much magnetic field from impacting friendly metals as possible. The next questions are, do I have to calibrate each of the systems individually? And how do I calibrate my system for the friendly metals? The good news is, once a system is calibrated, any duplicate systems can use the same calibration, as long as they're using exactly the same mechanical and electrical designs. Now we'll discuss the tools available to do the calibration. Calibration of your system requires external tools. Typically, we use the Avid Technologies Qi FOD transmitter to calibrate our receiver EVMs. The Avid tool requires a 19-volt power supply and a USB serial interface, which are both included with the system. TI provides an FOD GUI for the data analysis. This can be found in the Tools and Software tab of the receiver product you'll be calibrating. This GUI covers all of TI's receivers. Once you download the tool, you'll find the GUI in the Start menu. Included with the GUI is a detailed user manual that will give you more information on FOD and help walk through the process. The user manual details what equipment will be needed and why. It will cover many details that we don't have time for here. In addition, the TI GUI and the Avid tool we need, a source meter for the receiver load, an oscilloscope for measuring the voltage on the rect pin, a resistor decade box for RFOD capable of 1K ohms, and a resistor decade box for ROS capable of 500 kilo ohms, a voltmeter, hyperterminal or teraterminal to show the results from the Avid tool, and most importantly, you'll need your end equipment. Our next video will cover the lab data collection and the use of the GUI. Watch for more videos as we take a deeper dive into wireless power at ti.com/wirelesspower. Thanks for watching.